it's Ash. So I recently got this pack of Miru Fi Animal Crossing cards. I'm not really sure how you pronounce it. I'm probably butchering it. But basically, these cards allow you to layer them up so you can create like a scene inside of a house or something like that. You know, I've seen these cards a little bit, like I've seen other Animal Crossing collectors have these kinds of cards in their collection. I've never had any before, so I kind of kept an eyeball on, you know, possible deals on eBay, and finally I found one that came in this cool little box and everything, and it looks like it's like a whole board game, because there's like this whole like board setup, and like there's even like this dice over here. I'm not sure what that is about. I've never heard of that part. All I've heard is that there's different like items and rooms and characters, or villagers I should say, that you can collect, and then you can create basically a room. You can get points basically also by creating these things. I'm not very educated. I need to educate myself more, but what I did know is that I needed to start my collection of these. This only came out during Wild World, I believe. So today I'm gonna get started with my collection by opening this. So this set might be a little basic, but that's okay because I don't have any of these cards, so I will take the basics. These cards are also like plastic. They're like see-through plastic, and it's really cool seeing them for the first time in person, finally. So I'll put those aside there. I don't want to bend everything out of shape here, but yeah, I'm pretty sure this is like a dice, and I'm sure if I knew Japanese, I would see what the heck it's telling me. I'm guessing like you roll it, and like depending on what you roll, you play a certain type of card or something. I don't know. So this is the map that they were advertising on the front of the box. Let's just go ahead and open that real quick before we get into the cards. So, oh wow, and it's so vibrant. My goodness, yeah, I don't think this has ever been used because it looks and feels pretty new to me. So here's a good view of it. Look at all that Wild World artwork. It's so pretty and, like I said, very vibrant. And I love that we have, like, Pelly, and then we have her sister up here. We also have, like, Kiki on the cover here, and the classic Wild World girl villager outfits and everything, and Ruby. Like, I really like this mat. This mat is so cool. Can I use this for Pokemon cards? I know it's not meant for Pokemon cards, but can I use it for Pokemon cards? All right, so, and then there's this, and I'm pretty sure I was right that these are deck boxes. So let's go ahead and build our deck boxes so that way we have a place to put our cards. Okay, so there we go, and it is basically set. So I think also, based off of the construction, you can like put your cards, like discard your cards or something through this, I'm assuming? I'm not quite sure, but here's what the deck box looks like once it's all put together. You just have Tom Nook on both of the major sides and then Red on both of the little sides, so that's pretty neat. Alright, so let's start with this pack here. Let's just, you know, see what all goodies we got in this. Again, I'm pretty sure this is like a starter pack, but hey, I'm a beginner to collecting these kinds of cards. These Miru Fi. Miru Fi. I'm probably pronouncing it way wrong. Alright, so there we go. Alright, so of course the first card that we have is this one of Pascal. He's outside of a house, which is pretty cool. And then this next one we have is some furniture. So we've got like the exotic lamp, the exotic chair, and a panda. Oh, there's even a table underneath the panda. So that's pretty neat. And then we also have Margie here, just looking as cute as ever. Then we got another card for more items, which is like the exotic bed and the exotic screen. And then this is the exotic rug, I'm pretty sure. And then this is just a whole room. And this card right here is actually cardboard. This is like a regular card material, while the rest of these are more of the plastic variety because that way they can be see-through. So as I was saying before, it has like a point system here, and I guess that's how the game works, is like, you know, as you create these rooms, you get a certain amount of points. So like, for example, right now, I would now have 69 points for just putting this exotic rug on the ground. And then we also have, like, you know, if I add the little bed and screen here, that gives us 169 points. So we got 100 points just for adding those pieces of furniture. And then, you know, you add in Margie, and now it's 198. So we got, you know, quite a few points for adding the villager Margi. And then you add a little more, and it turns into 392, which is quite the jump there. And then you have the exterior decoration, and it creates it to be 398, which is pretty high. So yeah, that's essentially how it works, and I'm guessing with the game, this is total speculation, but with the game, like, you randomly pull the cards, you don't know what you have, and you just gotta try to make the most out of your points or something like that. I don't know. But still, pretty cool. I really like these cards, and like, they're so colorful, so really well designed. Like, just look, it's just like, I mean, look at that. It's just a clear plastic card. It's just such a cool concept. I really like that. And I'm sure this gives me all the instructions I could ever need to play the game, but I'm still just speaking English. Alright, so let's get into the second pack, see what cards I've got in this one. Okay, so this time I'm gonna go backwards. So starting with the last card here, the room card, which is a cardboard material, you just have a room with like the citrus wallpaper. I can't remember what it's called, but I feel like it's citrus. And then, you know, just a wooden plank flooring along with a cardboard box and a stereo, 9 points. So then we add a rug or a flooring, and we get 29 points, just adding like the fruit flooring or citrus flooring, whatever it's called, which is pretty cool. And then the next card is some of the fruit furniture. I guess I'll put this aside as I look at this, because here is the fruit furniture. I missed the pineapple bed. It was one of my first items ever in the GameCube game, and so it's just like a nostalgic item for me, so pineapple bed win. And then the pear dresser, so, and the Apple TV, of course, can't forget that. So if we put that onto our cards, we now have 188 points. All right, so then the next card is of Mabel? I think it's Mabel. or Sable. I can't remember which one is which, but essentially an adorable sewing hedgehog. And, you know, again, quality of these cards are so beautiful. This card alone is 61 points itself, but then you add it to the rest of this, and now our whole stack is worth 189 points. The next card is another fruit set. So we have the cherry shirt, the melon chair, melon table, and a whole bunch of fruit scattered on the table, which I love. This is 290, so what I'm noticing with this set of cards, along with the exotic theme, is that whenever you have like this card that adds like kind of like more decor, they tend to be a higher amount of points, so you definitely want decor items. And adding that all together, we now have 289 points. The last card is of the Able Sisters exterior, which is pretty cool. So we add that on top of everything, and then it's 389 points, which I guess that's like the most, because that's how much we got in the last one. But I want to take a closer look at this again, because I kind of just slid by it, but look at it! It's so cute! I love these cards so much! They're so interesting. Digging into the next pack here, we're gonna start with the last card now that we're educated about this. And this pack has the kitty wallpaper, along with just a cardboard box. I think there's actually a candle on there. Now that I'm looking closer at it, there's actually a candle on top of that cardboard box. And then along with the tape deck. So let's see, it's worth 5 points. And then we add the kitty rug, and then we're at 79 points, which is pretty good. Then adding some more furniture, we have 122 points, which is the kitty bed, the bookshelf, and the clock, which I want to give you a good look at how it looks without the background. Again, these cards are so, so freaking cool. And then we also have Peanut, which is just the most adorable card you could probably get in this whole set. Unless there's a Rosie card, I'm sure there is. But look at this, it's so cute! I love this so much, and they're so high quality. So then you add Peanut in there, and now it's 138 points. And next, oh, we got another villager card in this set. So this one comes with Daisy, I think her name's Daisy. And then you also get the, there's the 3D glasses along with the kitty table and the kitty chair. So I guess you could have friends over. That's neat. So 132? Yeah, 132 points there. And then the exterior we got with this pack is this Nook's Cranny shop area, which is pretty neat. Holy crap, that's 992? Is that right? 932? I think it's 932, actually. That's crazy. 932 points. This thing is a lot because, like, look at... That's like 5 on its own. It's like 500 points on its own. 512 points by itself is what I'm trying to say. One day, I'll get my point across. And the last pack that I have from this starter kit is starting with this cardboard card, which has, I can't remember if it's a bookshelf or a library wallpaper. I can't remember what it's called. But again, classic cardboard with candle, or cardboard box with candle and tape deck. And then the next card in this series is this the exotic flooring? I can't remember. Maybe it's not the exotic flooring. I can't remember what the name of this flooring is. But you get this fancy flooring, and that takes you from 6 points to 59 points. Hell yeah. And then you also get this card, which I've never been into the hospital-like series of furniture or office furniture, but it's okay. It's just not my cup of tea. But it's like the hospital bed along with the weight machine, this desk, and this chair and everything. It's pretty cool. Oh, and if you look, this picture has a picture of KK, a slider, in a photo frame, which is pretty neat. I like that. This card alone is 200 points. Wow, really? Wow, that's interesting. So there we go, 292 points to have all three of these together. Then we have little cute Ruby. Oh my goodness. Again, it's just so, I'm just in awe of how these cards look because, like, I don't know, like, I just never would have thought to design a card like this and, like, have such good, like, printing of, like, the villagers and stuff. Like, look at it. It's just so well done. So adding Ruby, it makes it 293 points. Then adding this piece of furniture, wow, 292 points just for this card. But it comes with the skeleton. I can't for the life of me remember what this is. I think it's a heater of some sort, and then a weight measure behind it. So add that to here, and we have a nice little doctor's office that's worth 292 points. Holy crap, we were at 293, so it went down. Actually, maybe it's gone down in the other ones and I just never noticed because I'm a ditzy blonde lady, so. And then there's also this exterior of a pretty upgraded house. I love that there's a little balloon in it too, and you have Pete delivering you some mail to your mailbox. I love that. Adding that on top of everything, holy crap, 893 points. I just love that. That's so cool. So yeah, that's all of my cards that I got. And as you can see, each one is numbered E11, D11, C11. So there's these S cards, which are the room cards. And then you have your A cards, which is like your flooring. And then your B cards, which is just furniture. C cards, which are typically your villagers. D cards that are more furniture to add to your room, and then the E cards, which are the exteriors. So, because I saw that there's many different cards to collect, and they can be a little difficult to collect because, again, especially for someone like me who lives in America, these were only released in Japan, I'm pretty sure, back in the Wild World days, which means these are very hard to get now for me as an American. It'll be fun to, like, be scouring the internet for all of the different cards that I can possibly get. So for all of the e-cards, for example, which are just all exterior cards, they are all labeled with E, and I got 11, 12, 13, and 14, which, you know, that's super cool. So now I've got to make a list online so that way I can start making sure that as I browse for more of these cards that I don't get doubles. And, you know, maybe there's packs of these cards that I can find for a good price, so that way I can open more of these. But I'm super happy that I got this starter kit for the price that I did, because, you know, sometimes these old Animal Crossing items, they can be a little expensive. I'm just admiring, like, just the artwork. Just look at it. The artwork on these is just so good. It's so good. Like, I am so excited to put these in my album and, you know, hunting the rest of the collection down. I don't think there's a whole lot of cards in this set, thankfully. Not compared to, like, Amiibo or e-reader cards, so I already got all the Amiibo. Working on e-reader, and now this series. I don't know what I'm doing to myself. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and maybe you learned a thing or two about some of the old Animal Crossing merch that is out there. I love doing these videos because, you know, I just love screaming about things that I love on the internet, and Animal Crossing is definitely one of those things. So anytime I get something new, I want to scream about it. So yeah, that's why this video exists. If somehow you're a new person browsing my channel right now, first of all, I just want to say thank you, and for all of those who are returning, very much thank you. I really do appreciate anything you give me, a comment, a like, a view, a subscription, doesn't matter. I just appreciate all of it. Just all I'm trying to say is thank you for being here. I really appreciate it. And if you want to see more of my face outside of this channel, I have a Twitch channel that you can go and check out. I stream on Wednesdays, Saturdays, and Sundays. And then if you have the desire to support my channel whatsoever and you like photography prints, well, boy, do I got a story to tell you. I have a print shop, and in that print shop I have all these beautiful prints that you can purchase. I'm really proud of them, so I have them displayed in my house, and I hope you decide to display them in yours. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.